Hi, this is Lux, and before I get started, I want you to understand that even though I have Ableton Live open, this is not specific to that DAW. At the end of this tutorial, I'll use Logic, yet this would also work in any other DAW. The main focus here is on the plugin, and the plugin I'm using is called Patchwork by BlueCat. And if you're using Ableton Live, you're familiar with the instrument rack. In a way, this is very similar. There are some features of the instrument rack that BlueCat cannot do, and I kind of think that there are some things in BlueCat's patchwork that the instrument rack can't do, or if it can, it does it a little sloppier. And that's not a negative word, it just means that, as you'll see in a bit, BlueCat is all-inclusive plugin, whereas if you're using Instrument Rack, you're going to have multiple tracks, etc., and that might get a little messy when you have a large project. So what is Patchwork? Patchwork is essentially a host. It's a host for VSTs and for audio units, and it makes no difference what DAW you're using. It works in it. Pro Tools, Logic, Bitwig. You can use audio units in Bitwig. You can use VSTs in Logic. All right, well, I'll stop rambling and get to showing you how this works. And then I'm going to lead to a pretty complex patch. I think you're going to get excited about it like I did. Before I do that, though, I just want you to see that I'm using BlueCat right now to run my chain for speaking to you. That way I don't have to go through the DAW, I can just do it right here in Patchwork. So the way Patchwork works is you have this area called pre, the parallel chains, and the post. So I've kind of screen capped this off of the instruction manual, excuse the pixelation, but you can see the signal chain. The audio comes in and then it goes over and goes through the parallel chains and then top to bottom again on post. With that being known, I've limited this to a single line. We have a pre, post, and then a single parallel chain. And what I've done is I've put Vacuum Pro from Air in this chain, and I'm going to open that up, show the editor. And there's a little power switch off to the left. There's some gain off to the right, solo and phase. When you're using a synth, the gain on the left isn't going to affect it. So no need to turn that. But if you'll hear here, simple. I'm just playing the synth right here through track one in Ableton. Now, what I've also done is I've loaded a great plugin by Exfer called Cthulhu, which is a chord generator and an arpeggiator. And there's a little power switch you can see off to the left. I'm going to turn that on. I'm going to show this editor. And I have a little sequence here loaded. So what's really cool about Patchwork is that I can now route the MIDI notes from Cthulhu into Vacuum Pro. Now, I do that pretty easily just by clicking it. And I'm going to go down to MIDI output, excuse me, MIDI output. And you'll see there are multiple ports I can choose. In this case, I'm going to choose, as I have here, port A. I could choose port D, port O, it makes no difference. I'm going to choose port A. The MIDI input, it's coming straight from my host, just straight from my Nectar Panorama here. MIDI output again, I just set to port A. Okay, so we're going to go to Vacuum Pro. We're going to click on it, go down to MIDI input, and you'll see port A. I already have selected all channels. And now if I press a note, I like that. Now, what I'd like to do is show you how this can get even more powerful. Off to the left here, we have three columns. I could add a fourth, even a fifth, or more. Rows, We can now add a second row, third row, fourth row. And each one of these rows I can turn on and add an additional synth. I can add another MIDI effect that only operates the plugin that we route it to. So I could have four Cthulhus here off to the left, independently controlling four synths that I have effects off to their right, as many as I need, or at least as many as the plugin allows. And I could affect their volume, phase, and then glue them all together with some plugin compressor or whatnot on the post. And you have a single note, very powerful single patch that you can save. And then here's what's great about it. I can open this once I save it in Logic, or I can open it in Reaper. Those are the three I use. Okay, so I've opened up another patch that is essentially the same as the one we just were looking at, except I've added another row and a hybrid 3 synth from Air. And Cthulhu is operating Vacuum Pro, but hybrid is just being controlled as it normally would. So if I just turn off Vacuum Pro, you'll hear. And with Vacuum Pro, all right, so I have one note that's playing an ARP, another same note, but we have a bass line going along with it, or bass note. So what I've done, I have another preset that I saved, and what I've done here is I've added a little bit more. And as you'll see, on Vacuum Pro, I just went ahead and put in a vintage verb. So now we have. All right, hybrid's still the same and not affected by vintage verb at all, as they're running in parallel. One thing I forgot to mention, off to the right you have sum and average. When we're using synths, I would say always use sum. Average is going to work great if you're using an effects chain. But right now, and only an effect chain, but in this case, synths will work and be much happier volume-wise if we're using it in sum. Okay, so this next little preset is all I've added is an additional EQ after the vintage verb, and get rid of some of the low, let the bass peek through a little better, and it goes like this. Okay, so nothing to it. I think you can see the creative possibilities here. So what I've done is I went all out and did a more complicated patch. I'll share with you what's under the hood, and then we'll make a little tune with it over in Logic. Right. So in this patch, I have three Cthulhus. One of them is running hybrid to its right. The other is running Loom, and the third one is running the Tal sampler down at the bottom. So remember that the signal flow is not as it appears. I just want to reiterate that, because if you have a plugin, you assume it just is going straight across the parallel chain and out the post. But as this diagram again from their manual, BlueCat's manual for Patchwork shows, it's not the case. Remember, top to bottom, pre and post. Parallel chains are the only part of the plugin that's going from left to right. So when you see this, you're seeing this Cthulhu operating the hybrid to the right just by coincidence, and it's not the path it's taking. They are routed in the MIDI output to port A, and MIDI output, I'm using port B. And then MIDI output, guess what? It's port C. Then those are routed to the plugins of which I wanted to have them control. You look off to the right and see that I have a messed with the volumes just a little bit. The balance is there. And we have this hybrid. Let me turn these off, let you hear it. All right, we'll bring in the loom. Now let's add a little bass from vacuum. I'm liking it. And the TAL noisemaker, all I did was open up a default patch and just detuned it a bit. And this is what we have. And then the sampler adds just an additional movement. So kind of an 80s patch there. And together. Cool. Yeah, I was super excited when this all came together and I thought, wait a minute. This is going to be really useful. And when I save this, since I made a few little changes, and I can open this in Logic and continue on. Okay, here we are in Logic. You might have noticed when we were in Ableton that the CPU meter was off the charts. So that's something you need to be thinking about when you're just throwing a bunch of plugins into Patchworks like I was. But what I've done here is frozen the track that I'm using that patch on, so we won't have to hear all the CPU pops and clicks that would be inevitable. So this is a quick little melody I threw together using that patch we just listened to in Ableton, and I'm going to play a little bit of it, and then I'm going to drop some drums in right afterwards. Here you go. Cool. So yeah, that one patch already is doing so much. Went and just tucked in a little bit of what I'm calling 80s bell at this second part, and this is what it sounds like. All right, and also to kind of add some, for lack of a better word, filler, I saw some people or heard, read about some people doing this and gave it a try myself. So I took some noise and put a plugin called LFO Tool from Xfer Records. I don't think you can even hear it. At least I can't. I can tell when I unmute it, but here you go. Let's judge for yourself. Then I will scare you half to death with the fact that I sang a little bit. And this is the part I put in.
In the light beneath the window, where the beams are making shadows on the ground.
Then finally, a little bit of guitar at the end. All right, then all together. So thanks for watching. I'll hope to do at least one of these a week, probably one of these a week. And at the end, if I'm capable, I'll try to put a little teeny song together with what we talked about to kind of put everything together in context and send you off with that. Have a great day.